The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
We are here today in the Rip Griffin Center at the men's and women's basketball games, and we presented a wish to Angel Martinez. We brought him in as our guest. Throughout the whole game, we would have little contests and things that he would win. Our first surprise was to do a name drawing, and then he got a signed basketball from our basketball players. Our second surprise for Angel was he got to go on the court and drive a remote control car into each Star Wars figure, and every one that he hit, he got a prize. And then his final surprise was a fake costume contest, which it was actually his wish reveal that we got to grant him.
So everybody thinks this is a costume contest, but it actually isn't. We're actually here for someone much more special to us. So that special someone is Angel Martinez. You're going to Legoland!
The best part about this is that all of the athletes and a lot of the community here at LSU get to come together and work really hard to raise this money just so that we can make someone's day extremely special.
The academics at LSU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask if I have any problems? How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The national SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved.
Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports. Athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Heartland Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are.
We are.
We are.
We are St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
At Roger State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Rogers State University.
I knew I would earn my degree from a great school. But I never imagined this experience. It's changed the way I think about my future and transformed how I see my world.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
At Newman University, you'll receive more than just a degree. You'll receive a degree of merit, a degree of character, a degree of difference. Learn more at newmanu.edu.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
We open our arms to students from around the corner and from around the world.
No matter where we're from, all Dust Devil student athletes play for the love of our sport, the love of our team, and the love of our university. If you can play here, you can play.
If you can play,
you can play.
Om du kan spela, så kan du spela.
Si muchas rat, muchas rat.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
If you can play, you can play.
I came here to get my degree at a great school. Along the way, I worked at an orphanage in India and taught school in Peru. It's changed how I look at the world and how I see my future.
Newman University in Wichita. Newman is a family that comes together to excel in the classroom and on the field. As the only private NCAA Division II university in Kansas, our student athletes are uniquely prepared for success beyond college. Newman University, empowering graduates to transform society. Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
He is the God who sees me. He knows who I am becoming and who I will one day be. The kingdom of God. This is no small stake. With all my heart, mind, and strength, I will answer the call.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
This is the U that goes beyond a bachelor's degree. This is the International U, Texas A&M International University. Learn how to take your talents further at tamiu.edu.
Whoever you are, whoever you want to be, find your future with us. We are UAFS.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Defining moments, championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
We are here today in the Rip Griffin Center at the men's and women's basketball games, and we presented a wish to Angel Martinez. We brought him in as our guest. Throughout the whole game, we would have little contests and things that he would win. Our first surprise was to do a name drawing, and then he got a signed basketball from our basketball players. Our second surprise for Angel was he got to go on the court and drive a remote control car into each Star Wars figure, and every one that he hit, he got a prize. And then his final surprise was a fake costume contest, which it was actually his wish reveal that we got to grant him.
So everybody thinks this is a costume contest, but it actually isn't. We're actually here for someone much more special to us. So that special someone is Angel Martinez. You're going to Legoland!
The best part about this is that all of the athletes and a lot of the community here at LSU get to come together and work really hard to raise this money just so that we can make someone's day extremely special.
The academics at LSU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation. Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask if I have any problems? How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The national SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved.
Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Enough.
Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports. Athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Heartland Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are.
We are.
We are.
We are St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
From the UMAC in Tulsa, Oklahoma, it is day two of the Heartland Conference Championship Tournament. Game one, Lubbock Christian taking on the Newman Jets. This tournament game day number two gets kicked off right now here on the Heartland Conference Sports Network. And we welcome you back to the UMAC here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. It is the Union Multipurpose Activity Center. It is the home of the 2017 Heartland Conference Championship. Day two of quarterfinal action pitting the defending national champions, the Lubbock Christian Lady Shaps and the Newman Jets, one-on-one here in game number one of day two. Hello again, everyone. My name is Drew Brent alongside Corey Riggs courtside. Jose Harper is our man on the sideline. And, Corey, we're taking a look at this matchup. And, you know, not a whole lot of difference between these two teams when you actually start to break it down, despite the differences in seeding and record.
No, but the one big difference is you said it right off the top of the show. The Lady Shaps are the defending Division II national champions. They feature the player of the year in the Heartland Conference, Tess Bruffy, who just in the final regular season game dropped a career-high 30 points against St. Edward's. This is a team with a lot of offensive firepower, and to borrow a phrase, this is kind of the irresistible force and the immovable object. Lubbock Christian can put up a lot of points, Drew, and what Newman does better than anybody is put the clamps down on defense and force you to turn over the ball. They force 19 turnovers a game through the conference season. They find a way to get the ball and get points in transition.
These two teams split the regular season series. Matter of fact, take a look at this statistic here, Corey. Newman won six of their last seven in the regular season with only one loss in that series. That loss coming from Lubbock Christian and the Lady Shaps. And, you know, as we've been talking about this, you look at a 3-6 seeding, there's not a whole lot of difference here. And as we mentioned, the defending national champions, but this Newman team had a 10-game winning streak going early on in the regular season before the wheels proverbially came off around Christmas. They were able to get it back on track.
Yeah, it was an incredible run. They dropped the first two games of the year, then went 10 in a row, including three on a road trip to Alaska. And so they did really well there. And then two games before Christmas, they suffered a one-point loss and a blowout loss. They got Christmas break. They come back, they lose again. And then it was three wins in a row, three losses in a row, four wins in a row. So it's been an up-and-down season for Newman, but all of that gets thrown out the window when you get to postseason play.
Lady Shaps in their home white, blue trim, red stripes, and Newman will control in their away red, white numerals and blue trim, and we are underway day two. Immediately Newman trying to open things up, and you see that their pace is frantic. They've got some ball movement, very, very fast, and an inside two-point shot off the rail will not go, will go out of bounds.
Newman has that tough defense, but they are able to score the ball as well, Drew. Number 15, Hannah Alexander, is the league's newcomer of the year, and this Jet offense features three of the league's top 11 scorers.
Hannah Harbin would take the ball out of the backcourt and move it into the front court for the Lady Shaps at the top of the key now. And once again, you see the Shaps doing what they do best. Nice little dish underneath along the baseline. Two-point shot will not fall, and Newman will take the rebound. Jets across the time stripe here in the early going. First quarter action, just over 9 minutes to play. Eyes the three-point shot, decides not to take it, and a cross-court pass to Ortiz. Now on the baseline inside dish, a little bit tangled up underneath, whistle and a foul call.
Mally Wright, an all-conference second-teamer that time, a good size post, 6'1", a four-year player for this team, and their head coach, Darren Spence, but nice interior passing from block to block, but three defenders there at the point of attack, so they'll have the inbounds here after the stoppage, just barely a minute in, and there you get a good look. Darren Spence in his fifth year at the helm of the Newman Jets women's team.
Jasmine Ortiz with the inbounds pass, and on the two-point shot, that is Hannah Alexander, and as you mentioned, we've already called her name a couple of times today. She gets the first points of the afternoon.
She's the number seven scorer in the conference.
Three-pointer on the way will bounce out off the backboard. And say that again, Corey, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, she's just the number three, or the number seven scorer in the conference. But her numbers jumped up exponentially in conference play. When you take the non-conference out, she's become even more deadly against the team she gets to see twice a year.
Here's Houseman with the basketball. We'll now move it to Alexander on that far side, looking, trying to drive inside the paint. This is what Newman likes to do, play inside, try to get the boards. The Shaps have the basketball. 8.5 to play in this first quarter, still 2-0. Over on this near side now, trying to work the ball around the circle, not really finding their shot, but being very watching their pace and trying to set up the offense. Three-pointer from the wing, it's up and it's in. Nice shot that time. And it puts the Shaps on the board. A great shot that time from Bailey Heist.
Heist knocks down her 54-3 of the season.
Two-point shot to answer back, will not go, and the Shaps take it the other way. That is Harbin taking it, and she's going to push it now back to Duffy. And now working back the outside, Bruffy. Two-pointer off the board, nice little kiss off of the glass, and a nice job that time by Harbin to get underneath in the paint and puts it off the glass.
Hannah Harbin, her first 2 points of the afternoon. She averages 8 points and about five rebounds a night for Lubbock Christian.
Here's Harbin, three-pointer on the way, will not fall. Newman with the rebound. Goes to Mally Wright, and she'll kick it out to Jaden at the top of the key. Here in the early going, in day number two of the Heartland Conference Championship Tournament, the defending national champions leading 5-2 over Newman.
There you get a good look at 14th year head coach Steve Gomez, the reigning national coach of the year, after leading the Lady Shaps to that D2 national championship against University of Alaska Anchorage.
The first team in women's Division II to win the national championship in their first season of eligibility. The inbounds pass goes to Jaden, and now driving inside, trying to find that inside shot, and so far Newman has not had a lot of luck in the paint. 7:07 to play in the first quarter. Inside, two-point shot off the rim, will not go. Another miss that time by Alexander, who has the only 2 points for Newman on the afternoon so far. It's Delaney Gaddis out to Bobby Chitsey in the wing, and then now trying to move it inside to Bruffy. Bruffy turnaround, trying to find the shot, will not go. Hannah Alexander with the hand check foul.
She reached in, trying to deny the conference player of the year in Tess Bruffy. And that is going to be a lot of work. 6'4" and a junior from Lubbock, Texas, where Lubbock Christian is located. You see the foul. She goes to the free throw line today for the first time, knocks down the first free throw. The leading scorer on the team at 16 points a game. She also adds 8.5 rebounds. Say she is prolific on both ends of the floor. You know what? This is a team two partner that last year had the player of the year in the conference. Turn around, two different players, but back-to-back years, that award goes to the Lady Shaps.
Smix is the second one. Maintains 5-2. Newman on the other end, who's Alexander again. Setting it up, Bria DeGrade in for Newman now as well. She'll have the basketball on the far side, working this circle. Still trying to find that inside game partner, not seeing what they want to go with, but a three-point shot will not fall, and the Shaps will take it the other way.
Another good rebound by Heist, and the guards for this Lubbock Christian team do a good job of working the glass.
Heist over to Bruffy, now inside the paint. Two-point shot will not fall, this time for Bailey Heist. A little scramble for the basketball, whistle and a foul. They're going to call that one on Sierra Jaden.
Jade, the 5'10" guard you see her in the middle of your screen wearing number 10, been playing for the last few weeks with a broken thumb. She's got that taped up on the left hand, and see the little reach in from behind.
Three-pointer on the way, will not fall. Bobby Chitsey takes the long three. That's an NBA range three. Couldn't quite get it to fall. Two-point jumper up and nicely done. Hannah Alexander just pops, locks, and drops it at the charity stripe, and it's 6-4. Here's Bruffy on the wing. Looking inside now, gets it to Chitsey. Chitsey still trying to work inside the paint. Looking for the shot, turnaround will not go. She's whistled, and it's a foul.
Great post play for this Lubbock Christian women's team. When you look at the size they've got, 6'4" in Tess Bruffy, 6'1" here in Bobby Chitsey, a sophomore from Wall, Texas, who plays on this team with her sister Maddie.
That's the second set of sisters on this Lubbock Christian team.
Chitsey's and Bruffy's. And that's not the most we're going to see today, because in one of the men's games later, there's four sets of brothers, three sets of players, and one set of brothers on the coaching staff.
It's a family tradition here in D2 and in the Heartland, apparently, and that's okay with us. It's an 8-4 ball game. Lubbock Christian leading with 5:24 to play. Ball bounces off of the leg of Delaney Gaddis. Last touch, however, by the Lady Shap, so the inbounds pass will come from Grzetska. Two-point shot, jumper, got a little piece of it, did Bruffy, and they're going to go the other way. Nice defensive play that time by Tess Bruffy to put her finger on the ball and disrupt the shot. Now Chitsey at the top of the key. Three-pointer on the way from Heist, trying to steal one, but couldn't quite get it.
That was the 259th career block of Tess Bruffy. She not only is the leader in that statistical category at her school, but in the Heartland Conference, and she's only a junior.
Underneath, Newman still struggling inside the paint. Alexander may have gotten away with one right there. Coming into the game now will be Olivia Robertson for Lady Shaps, and that will lead us to our first media timeout. 8-4 is your score in game number one of day two of the Heartland Conference Championship Tournament. Back after this on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Your score, Lubbock Christian leading over Newman. And partner, we were talking about it during the break. Newman not able to find their shot underneath, and some surprising statistics coming out of that first time out.
Take a look at the stats coming out. 2 of 11 shooting. Drew, they're committed to getting the ball in the low post and trying to take high percentage shots, but Hannah Alexander is the only player for the Jets to make a field goal. 2 of 5 for her. The rest of the team, you know, shooting 2 of 11 with her two makes. Now they're doing well at the free throw line, and in the early going, that makes it a one possession game. But on the other side, Lubbock Christian, 2 of 7 from the floor. They've already knocked down a 3-2, which helps.
Ruffy will inbound the basketball to Olivia Robertson, who's fresh into the game. Dishes it to Gaddis, who takes it across the time stripe, and the Lady Shaps will reset their offense at 4:34 to play. In this first quarter, they dish to Harbin, and now in the wing, inside looking for Bruffy. Bruffy, two-pointer off the glass, and she gets it to fall. Pinballs around and able to get it to fall.
Great job using the left hand that time. I thought that one was going to roll off the back of the iron, but it got a friendly roll here inside the UMAC.
Inside, two-point shot will not go. Once again, that's Mally Wright. All conference honors for Miss Wright, but couldn't get that one to fall. And a nice job to save the basketball from flying out of bounds. There's Bruffy again along the baseline inside the paint. And once again, the Lady Chefs finding the lane and utilizing it.
5 points now for Tess Bruffy, starting to show you a little bit of why she's the player of the year in the Heartland Conference. Going to be a dominant post presence, not only this year, but next year as well.
Lady Chefs seem to be ready for whatever it is that Newman is trying to do, but right now you also have to think that the lack of shooting inside is really hurting the Jets. 12-6 your score.
They really like Des Newman to kind of pack this zone back in, and right now Lubbock Christian doing a good job of just attacking and taking what they give them right now.
Alexander inside dish and walk.
Hannah Alexander had the opportunity to score in transition, but did not have the ability to keep her feet under.
And that was the first really solid look that Newman has had this game, really, as they took it into transition, had that open lane, and she takes an extra step. Harbin has the basketball and will give to Heist between the circles and resetting the offense. That's to Olivia Robertson, and a three-point on the way, not anywhere close for Claire Bruffy, the sister of Tess Bruffy. Alexander driving along the baseline, two-point shot will not fall. The rebound goes to Robertson.
Those have got to start falling sometime for Newman. That's a good shot. Defense wasn't bad. She had a clear line of sight, but just right now, kind of like there's a lid on the rim on this opposite end of the floor.
It's a 6-2 run in favor of the Lady Chefs right now. Shot clock down to 7-6, and now the two-point shot will bounce off the iron. It will not go. Whistle and a foul. I believe they're going to call that on Hannah Harbin. But
Harbin picks up her second personal, the team's third. Lady Chefs want to make a couple of changes. They send Delaney Gaddis back in.
Newman will take it out of the backcourt. 2.5 to play in this first quarter. The defending national champions up 12-6 along the baseline. Two-point shot up and in. Nice job at bringing in great. A bench player who we were talking with some officials earlier. They told us she's going to be very productive coming off of that bench.
Well, she was in the starting lineup early in the season and now has been even more successful, kind of in a six-man first option off the bench. She's an instant offense and a spark for this Jet team.
One of the team's leading scorers as well with 13.6. There she is to Great from the wing. Three-pointer on the way will not fall. The rebound, however, goes to Newman. They're going to get a second chance, and they really needed that. They can get it to fall. That would even be better for the Jets right now. DeGray, they found her in the corner again. Second three-point attempt will not fall. Trying to find a spark, couldn't quite get there, and the Chefs will take it in transition.
Well, it's not for lack of good looks at the basket. They kind of committed to the three in that last possession, and almost a great anticipation and steal by Bria DeGray.
A nice disruption that time, too. You know, a lot of coaches will tell you that great defense doesn't necessarily always have to be a steal, but a lot of times it's just disrupting the play, and that time Bria DeGray did exactly that. So the inbounds pass will come from Olivia Robertson, 5'10 sophomore out of Kerrville, Texas. Allie Harris into the ballgame now as well for the Lady Chefs. Good shot there. Our production crew doing a great job. Inbounds goes to Heist, and Heist will take it across the time stretch. Bruffy at the top, inside to Heist. Heist along the baseline. Nice little dish. Two-pointer on the bus. Just can't get it to fall that time. But the Chefs with the rebound. It was a great look for Olivia Robertson, but she couldn't get it to fall. Here's Heist, nice little ball movement inside. Cannot find it again, and so far the paint has been the issue, and a charge call. We're going to call that one on Bailey Heist.
Don't know what you'll see here, but it's a matter of Heist released
forearm.
The shot and then put the forearm out, ran over the defender. Say Steve Gomez going to plead his case, but he's not going to get anything to change here. His team still got a four-point advantage, but Newman's got the ball again.
20 seconds on the shot clock. Under a minute to play here in this first quarter. Inside the paint now and dish back out to the outside. Ortiz and a travel call.
Jasmine Ortiz just kind of drug her pivot foot when she started her dribble. And all of a sudden, Coach Darren Spence, jacket's off. The smile's gone from his face, and this is getting serious.
There's Heist. Heist to Bruffy. Bruffy now with the gaps now. And then to Robinson. Bruffy at the top. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Back to Bruffy. Nice little move. Now a dish to the wing. Robinson along the baseline. Can't find any help. Loses in on the basketball. Nearly with an over and back. 3-2-1. Trying to pick foul. That's a shot clock violation. And great defense that time by Newman. Disrupting what it is that the Lady Chaps are trying to do. But you also have to admit that it's at least a little bit of miscommunication there and some mental errors from Lubbock Christian.
Well, and I don't know why, because the Lubbock Christian bench and coaching staff were all counting down the shot clock. It's not like you couldn't hear it.
He's getting a little chippy on the inside. Turnaround two-pointer will not go for Newman, and that's been the case for them all day. 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Lubbock Christian's bench trying to put out a sense of urgency. 3 seconds, can't find the shot. 1 second left. Heist throws it up for a play at the end of the first quarter, and that's how we are going to end it. Score 12-8. First quarter is over. We will come back with more right after this on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Welcome back to the UMAC here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Lubbock Christian leading 12-8 here in this quarterfinal matchup and day two of the 2017 Heartland Conference Championship. We will hear from Jose Harbor here in just a few moments, but right now as we're taking a look at the statistics, we're seeing right now Newman, the story of the game so far for the statistics, 3-17 from the floor.
Yeah, the percentages kind of bear out when you've got an offense that's only connecting at a 17.5% clip. You're not really able to get a lot scoring-wise, but still, Drew, you say that, and it's only a four-point game.
Right, 4-for-14 for Lubbock Christian coming out of that as well, and it feels like there may be a lid on the basket for both of these teams. All right. Coming out of the timeout, let's hear from our man Jose Harbor. Jose.
Thanks, guys. I was listening into the timeout for Lubbock Christian, and Coach Gomez was telling his players, like, calm down, guys. You know, no need to rush the ball. No need to push anything that or force it. We just need to calm down and run our offense. Watch number 15 for Newman. You got to anticipate that she's going to put up a shot. Other than that, just play our game.
Excellent report there, Jose. And one of those things that he was talking about was slow down. Take your time. Ball control is something that we talked about all day yesterday. Execution, you know, just that executive style of trying to play. And once again, that becomes a factor here in conference tournament play, especially here in this opening round action.
Well, and this is a team, Drew, that you can use the phrase, been there, done that. When you make a national title run, and let alone a successful one, like the Lady Chaps have, this is a business-like approach. They run this like a business. And these young ladies know what it takes to get back to the pinnacle of their sport. They're going to lock this down, and I think you're going to see a different performance here in the second quarter.
Bria DeGreat on the outside, now pushing it back to the top of the key. She eyes the three. She tries it, cannot find it. Newman with the rebound, whistle, and a foul.
Looked like Allie Harris got underneath that time and gets the foul. Not really in a position, just kind of got knocked down to the floor. You see the release on the three from DeGreat, and then she ends up on the hardwood underneath Hannah Alexander and draws her first.
So the inbounds pass will come from Newman. Still 14-8, just under 10 to play. DeGrade over here on the near side. And there's Krzyzewska working the circle, now trying to find something inside. Gets it out to DeGrade for three. It's up. It's off the iron. It will not fall. Rhea DeGrade has eyed that outside shot for most of the time that she's been in. Has not been able to find any success with it. And here's Olivia Robertson on the other side. Down to Bruffy inside to Chitsy now. Trying to find the two-pointer, will not go, and she'll dish back out to Gattis. Both teams bearing down on the paint, and here we are again, another run deep inside the shot clock. Loses her handle on the basketball, does Gattis.
Yeah, nobody touched it that time. She just spun in the lane to try and avoid the contact and gives the ball back to the Jets. You're talking about the three-point woes so far for DeGrate. That is not normal. She's 50 of 149 on the season. She normally can knock it down from the perimeter. She's just got to shoot out of this little slump.
Steal for the Lady Chefs this time, trying to get some kind of offensive spark. In the two consecutive possessions, they've gone deep inside the shot clock. Here's Chitsy on the wing.
Well, they've got an easy way to fix that, partner. All they got to do is get the ball to 54, and that's what they do here.
Nice little head fake, and she loses her handle on it. And there's Natalia Hausman with a nice steal. Newman to DeGrade. Newman will have it. DeGrade on the three. She'll dish. Three-point shot will not go. And Lubbock Christian able to rebound. That's a missed opportunity for Newman.
She's going to shoot one until she makes one, man. You could just tell.
Robertson along the baseline will get it to the wing. Three-pointer up on the way. It will not fall. Here's Newman with the rebound.
Harris had a wide open look. Nobody came out and put a hand in her face. You can't knock her for taking an open look like that.
Krzyzewska working the circle, and now back to the wing. She'll dish it out to Alexander, who's trying to find something open, and back to Krzyzewska. 13 seconds in the paint. Nice little dish. It's stolen away, and the Lady Chefs will go the other way. They're in transition working, trying to find that layup. Goes hard to the paint. Two-point putback will still not go, and Newman coming back. Here's DeGrade. DeGrade's going to try to pop it up, and then you see her shake her head. No, we're not going to look. We're going to restart.
See if they get a ball reversal here and send it back to her. Instead, they attack, and that's a good one.
Hausman with a nice move inside. Puts up 2 points, and it's 14-10.
Well, it's a little rope-a-dope. The last three times down, it's been perimeter. That time, Hausman faked from the outside, drove the lane, and was able to finish at the rim.
Robertson being harassed by Hausman at the top, and now gets it out to Bruffy. She mentioned the conference player of the year, but so far she's been relatively silent. And once again, deep in the shot clock, Chitsy for three. It will roll out, no good, and Newman will take it the other way. Shooting woes for both teams continue.
19% for Newman, 23% for Lubbock Christian. It is a not a kind rim day here on a Friday.
Inside, now the dish to Krzyzewska. Whistle, and I believe we're going to have 3 seconds. 6:29 to play, several substitutions. Bailey Heist makes her way back in. Caitlin Cunyas in for the Lady Chaps as well. A couple of Newman players substituted. We will get those names when I see who they are. Jasmine Ortiz is back in the game as well.
Along with Carolina Bianchi. I think that's the first time we've seen Bianchi this afternoon.
Here's Cunyas working out to that far wing. 18 seconds to shoot. Not finding anything inside, and here's Bruffy. Once again, shot clock underneath 10, 6 seconds, five. Here's Bruffy for three, it's up. It's off the front of the iron, no good again, and we crash into the bench.
That, my friend, is what I like to call aggressive play. Both players going for it, but you saw there, it was Wright that was trying to just kind of block out. She knew who touched the ball last, and the collision into the Newman bench.
Here's DeGrate working on that far circle. Both teams having trouble finding their shot so far. Here's DeGrate on the inside. Two-pointer will not fall. The shooting woes for DeGrate continue, although this time she had a little bit of opposition.
Now the defense is flowing to Bria DeGrate right now. They know that she's kind of become the shot taker for this Jet team. That time she puts her head down, drives, and we'll see what she can do at the charity stripe.
And she misses the first one. Bria DeGrade has 2 points. 0 for 3 from the field goal line, 0 for 1 from the free throw line, 1 for 4 from the court, and not typical for Bria DeGrade.
No, she's a pretty good free throw shooter there. She misses the first, makes the second. She's 93 of 137 for a little over 68% from the line this season.
Gunyas to Heist, and Heist, nice little spin move, gets a screen from Chitsey. Now Chitsey on the inside, just going to work the circle, work the paint, 2-point shot. That's the offense that the Lady Shafts are looking for.
Wow, and that little spinner there, I didn't think it was going to get up over the lip of the rim, but it kind of spun around like a good shot on a pool table and just fell in.
16-11, your score, 2-pointer up and in for Hausman. Nice job there, and it got a little bit of air. As the Shafts will take it, the Shafts will take it across the court. Here's Cunyas. Once again, working the circle are Lubbock Christian, the defending national champions. Now working the baseline, trying to find the shot inside. That's where they were looking for, right there. Hannah Harbin underneath, and you hope, if you're Newman, that Lubbock Christian hasn't found their rhythm.
Hannah Harbin averages 8 points and 5 rebounds a night, and that was as good a looking shot as Lubbock Christian has had this afternoon, as she went all the way up and under for two.
2-pointer up and in for Newman. It's 18-15 and back to a one possession game.
That Natalia Hausman is just all over it today. She's already got 8 points. She leads all scorers in this one.
More than half of the offense attributed to Hausman for Newman today.
She's not even in the top three scoring on the Jets stat sheet, but she's leading them here today.
Conference play, conference tournament play changes things. There's Chitsey in the paint, 2-pointer up, and she gets it up and in. That seems to be Chitsey's bread and butter when she's on, and it goes back to being a two possession ball game, 20-15. 3-pointer on the way from DeGrade. She cannot find the shot. Lubbock Christian with the rebound. Heist is going to take it across the timeline here. Nice little dish over to Bruffy. 2-pointer up, whistle, foul.
Bruffy able to draw the defense to her that time. A little head fake, not in a hurry, drives, draws the contact, and she'll shoot a couple after we get a timeout.
We'll take the timeout with them. It is 20-15, game number one of day two of the Heartland Conference Championship. Back with more action after this.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
We are here today in the Rip Griffin Center at the men's and women's basketball games, and we presented a wish to Angel Martinez. We brought him in as our guest. Throughout the whole game, we would have little contests and things that he would win. Our first surprise was to do a name drawing, and then he got a signed basketball from our basketball players. Our second surprise for Angel was he got to go on the court and drive a remote control car into each Star Wars figure, and every one that he hit, he got a prize. And then his final surprise was a fake costume contest, which it was actually his wish reveal that we got to grant him.
Back here on the Heartland Conference Sports Network, Drew Brent, Corey Briggs, courtside. Jose Harbor is our man on the sideline here today. JBM production team punching all the buttons and making us sound much better than we are, Corey, and so we appreciate them. The Lady Shafts leading 20-15.
It's impressive. Normally I sound like Kermit the Frog in most conversations.
I'd heard that about you. Bruffy will go behind the line coming out of the timeout. She's got 5 points on the afternoon, make it 6 as she sends the first one.
She's a 62% free throw shooter on the season, 66 of 105. She's been to the free throw line almost twice as many times as any of her teammates.
She'll miss the second one. It will extend the lead 21-15. The Lady Shafts before the timeout were really finding some momentum, and now here's Ortiz. Ortiz to Alexander, a two-pointer up and in. Shannon James also in the ballgame for Newman, 21-17.
The shots finally starting to fall for Hannah Alexander. She's 3 of 7 now and has 6 points this afternoon. They've got it back down to that magic number of 4, Drew. That's kind of been the hump they haven't been able to get over against Lubbock Christian.
Once again, you're going to see some impressive defense on the inside. If Newman can get the shots to fall, they might be able to find that offensive spark. Here's James now.
Lady Shap
step.
Lady Shap switching up into a 2-3 zone. See if Newman can exploit that. And here's a tie-up.
Alternating possession arrow will go to Newman. The inbounds pass is to Jasmine Ortiz. Pass to James, the top, moving to DeGreat. Now back out to James. James, nice little move trying to find that scoring lane and can't quite get there.
It was an athletic move just to go up and get that pass. It was way too tall, but the 5'7" guard able to get it.
Two-pointer on the way from Allie Wright. She saw conference honors before this tournament started. Now Olivia Robertson on the other end. Baseline, two-pointer. Up and in, underneath. Lubbock Christian, it's like a well-oiled machine. And they can get those shots to fall, they will dominate the paint. And the ball flies out of bounds.
The field goal percentage was in the teens when we were talking about the first quarter. Now both teams, Newman shooting around 30%, Lubbock Christian shooting around 35%.
Just trying to find that offensive rhythm, trying to find their shots. It's 23-19, once again, that 4-point deficit that you mentioned. Bria DeGreat, get it to Wright, right inside, 2-pointer will not go, but Gruffy takes it away from her. Heartland Conference Player of the Year, making her presence felt defensively, and now at the top of the key, closely being guarded by Wright. To Cunyas. Three-pointer on the way, off the iron, will not go. Rebound, however, to Lubbock Christian. Nice job along the baseline and get out to Bruffy, and she stepped.
Gaddis, it was maximum effort trying to get the rebound, giving up some size, but comes down with it, and then just taken out by the heel of her shoe as she stepped on the out-of-bounds line.
The product of Glenwood Springs, Colorado, trying to fight for that basketball underneath. Alexander now out to the great far side. Now Mally Wright into James. And once again, Newman trying to look inside. You see the players as they're looking. They're trying to find that lane. The Lady Shaps have it covered up. Here's James again. Nice athletic play to get inside the paint. Loose handle on the basketball, whistle.
Contact with Shianna James that time. Bailey Heist had to stand her ground. You see James a little out of control as she put a shoulder into the gut of Bailey Heist. And
not great for a basketball player, but great for a linebacker.
It was a textbook form tackle. I'm in a complete agreement with you. But in basketball, it's called a foul.
So here's Cunyas along the circles, and we'll get it out to Heist. Heist back to Cunyas. Eyed the three, decided against it. Picked up her dribble, trying to find some help. Finds it in the form of Robertson, and the Lady Chef still trying to find it inside. Contact made. Once again, that forearm coming into play, and if we have that replay, we'll take a look at it, because the officials were telling us yesterday that forearm coming up is almost always a telltale sign that you're going to have the foul call.
And for Newman, not good on who the foul call came against either. It's the second on Hannah Alexander. They're all conference first teamer. They're just kind of waiting for Alexander to kind of wake up on the offensive end, and she has in this quarter now with 6 points on a 3 of 7 shooting day.
Along the baseline, and Heist not able to get it to fall. Just about 50 seconds to play here in this first half. That's back out. This time it looks like she's got it to DeGreat, and DeGreat working the circle. 14 on the shot clock. There's Wright. Newman still looking inside, but there's Bruffy trying to shut it down. She's got an arm up, and there she is. She did disrupt it. Again, 2 seconds left on the shot clock. Ball flies out of bounds. Lady Shaft's basketball. That was great defense by Lubbock Christian.
Lubbock Christian going to use the 30-second timeout here. It's great defense. You can't make a national championship run without having great defense. And the blocks that Tess Bruffy provides, now 200 and I believe 61 and counting. It's just unreal. Or yeah, 261. She came in today with 258. And the block shots, and even when she doesn't block them, Drew, just the length, the wingspan, she disrupts what teams want to do on the interior, on the offensive end of the floor. And that's why those shooting numbers are so low. And you pair her with a 6'1" sophomore and Bobby Chitsey, that's a great 1-2 punch.
She has a 3-inch advantage over anybody on the Newman roster as the two teams get back out onto the court. I want to remind you, this is only game one of a quadruple header here on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
The month of March is upon us, my friends.
And it is madness already. We saw a 7-seed win yesterday. We'll have complete tournament bracket recap a little bit later on. Here's Harbin. 6 seconds, 5 seconds, 4 seconds. Looking for Chitsey. 3 seconds. Chitsey going to have to throw up a prayer. Shot blocked. Bruffy before the buzzer. Can't get it to fall. And that's been the story of the Lady Chaps so far in this first half. 23-19, your score as we go into the locker room. Stay with us. More to come. The second half coming up right after this here on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask if I have any problems? How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The national SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved.
Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports. Athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Heartland Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are.
We are.
We are.
We are St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
At Rogers State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Rogers State University.
I knew I would earn my degree from a great school, but I never imagined this experience. It's changed the way I think about my future and transformed how I see my world.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
At Newman University, you'll receive more than just a degree. You'll receive a degree of merit, a degree of character, a degree of difference. Learn more at newmanu.edu.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
We open our arms to students from around the corner and from around the world.
No matter where we're from, all Dust Devil student athletes play for the love of our sport, the love of our team, and the love of our university. If you can play here, you can play.
If you can play,
you can play.
Om du kan spela, så kan du spela.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
If you can play, you can play.
I came here to get my degree at a great school. Along the way, I worked at an orphanage in India and taught school in Peru. It's changed how I look at the world and how I see my future.
Newman University in Wichita. Newman is a family that comes together to excel in the classroom and on the field. As the only private NCAA Division II university in Kansas, our student athletes are uniquely prepared for success beyond college. Newman University, empowering graduates to transform society.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
He is the God who sees me. He knows who I am becoming and who I will one day be. The kingdom of God. This is no small stake. With all my heart, mind, and strength, I will answer the call.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
This is the U that goes beyond a bachelor's degree. This is the International U, Texas A&M International University. Learn how to take your talents further at tamu.edu.
Whoever you are, whoever you want to be, find your future with us. We are UAFS.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Not a lot of shooting in the first half, but when it came, it was very important. Lubbock Christian leading 23-19 in this opening round matchup here, day two of the Heartland Conference Championship. Drew Britton, Corey Riggs here, courtside, about ready to bring you the second half. But right now we are going to go to our man on the sideline, Jose Harper, who has a report for us. Jose, go ahead.
Thanks, guys. I was able to talk to Coach Spencer of Newman as he was coming out of halftime, and I wanted to see what he could tell me, what he told his team at halftime. They're only down by four. He told them, you know, obviously we're not making shots. We need to stop making some careless turnovers. But he feels like they're too worried about what has happened instead of what's going on right now. He feels that if they can penetrate, that Lubbock just can't guard them up front. So let's see if that changes this half. Drew?
Jose, absolutely great stuff there, and you're right, because a lot of the stuff that we've been talking about through most of the game has really been more or less the lack of shooting that both teams have suffered from in the early going.
8 of 29 for Newman, 8 of 26 for Lubbock Christian. Both of these teams shooting around 30% from the floor. They are 1 of 18 combined from three-point land. We'll see what coaches' changes were made in the halftime intermission to try and kind of curb the shooting woes.
Three up and make that 1 of 19 between the two teams as Bailey Heist makes her first tray ball attempt of the second half. The inbounds pass will come to Jasmine Ortiz on the other side, and of course Newman seemed to try to establish an inside game, just could not get the shots to fall, and Alexander looking for another open opportunity. Here's DeBrayton now. Between the circles, resets inside. Nice little dish. Two-point shot will not go. It would have been a long two anyway for Mally Wright. And now the Lady Shacks will take it the other way. Up four.
Another rebound for Tess Bruffy. 6 points, five rebounds on the afternoon. Well below her scoring average, but I bet that changes here in quarter number three.
Whistle in 3 seconds in the lane, and Shacks will turn it over again. And just within this first minute, more missed opportunities. So you see Coach Spence coaching his team up, trying to find those open looks.
Turnovers even up, Drew, at 8 apiece.
Great job that time by Delaney Gaddis to get a foot out and disrupt. You know, as we mentioned before, defenders don't necessarily have to steal or block, just disrupt. It was a good job that time by Gaddis. As Newman resets, it is Mally Wright. She'll get it out to Houseman, and now Ortiz in the wing, working between the circles. DeGrace in the paint will try to move herself out, and she does, closely guarded by Bruffy, but she is screened out by Houseman.
After trying 8 or 9 three-pointers, they've changed to a 3-2 zone to try and deny the perimeter. That time, DeGrace drives the lane, but still can't find the rim.
She was along the baseline as well, just could not find that two-point shot. A little too much on it that time. Still 23-19, we're 90 seconds in.
The defensive mantra for Newman, deny, deny, deny. Look at them fly to the ball in this man-to-man defense.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. The Lady Shaps need to find it. 5 seconds left. Whistle, and I believe they called the charge there.
You're absolutely right. Heist.
Bailey Heist, and more contact. When you put that shoulder down or you put that forearm up, it's going to be a charge call.
Ortiz standing tough that time. Jasmine Jr. from Temple, Texas. Able to draw the contact, and there's so many opportunities here for Newman. We just sit on this 4-point differential.
From the wing, inside, Bruffy disrupts, Shaps come up with it. Bruffy will kick it out to Gaddis. Gaddis will take it across the timeline, and Lubbock Christian will reset. We are 2 minutes in and no scoring yet for either squad. Three-pointer on the way for Bruffy. She can't get it to fall either. Cold shooting from both squads. Make that one for 20. Here's DeBrayton. Three-pointer on the way, off the iron. Make that one for, what, 21 now?
And that was a good-looking shot, Drew. I mean, it's a good form. She was set, squared her shoulders to the rim. There was nothing wrong with the shot. The defense allowed her to have that. But this is a much better percentage shot. Bruffy still can't get it to go.
Bruffy on the inside to Gaddis. Gaddis finally puts it up and in. And nice cut that time for her, being able to find that shot from the paint, 25-19 now.
Great job by Tess Bruffy to drop the assist down, too. She could have easily turned around and just went back for the second chance points, but saw her teammate cutting, had a better chance.
There's Alexander, two-point jumper on the way and in, and there's Hannah Alexander from Farmington, Minnesota. 5'11", junior, puts the two-point shot up, and once again, back to that four-point differential we've talked about all game long, 6.5 left to play in this very quickly moving third quarter.
That is the magic number. Lady Shaps can't seem to get much more of a lead than 4-6, and Newman can never get over the hump to get it down to two.
Jitsi turnaround off the back of the rim will not fall. Newman resetting to the wing, goes Alexander driving the rim in the paint, two-pointer. She looked at it and then kicked it to the great three-pointer on the way. 1-22 now between the two teams from beyond the arc as Jasmine Ortiz misses.
The pace of play has changed a little bit on the Lubbock Christian end of the floor. They're trying to find a little bit more pacing here. See if that doesn't string out this stingy Jet defense.
Three-pointer on the way in. It's up and it's in. Finally, Delaney Gaddis able to put one in. The Glenwood Springs, Colorado native puts up the second three of the ball game. It's 28-21 now, a seven-point differential, and a steal. Lubbock Christian going the other way, trying to drive. They had a three-on-two disadvantage, and now inside the paint, nice dish inside. Ortiz, whistle and a foul.
And that was only the 11th three-point make all year for Gaddis. She's not even one of the primary three-point shooters. So it takes a rare person, somebody that doesn't normally make a three, to make one today in the UMAC.
Cunyas in for Lubbock Christian, Talia Hausman, and Shanna James back in for Newman. 5.5 to play in this third quarter. That has flown by. Here's Bruffy trying to drive the lane. Has it taken away from her. Her pocket gets picked. Hello, Newman. They're going the other way. DeGreat working the rim out to James. James kicks out to Hausman. Two-pointer up. Will not go. Whistle and a foul.
Hausman had 8 points, all of them coming in the first two quarters of play. 8 points and four rebounds. That was her first shot here in the second half. She tried to make something happen. Lubbock Christian with the ball now, Drew, 7 points is their largest lead of the day.
Brazilian native is not necessarily, as you mentioned, one of their top scorers, but here so far in this game, she's been most of the offense for Newman as Bruffy is on the inside. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Looking, still can't find anything open. 6 seconds, 5 seconds, Bruffy driving. Cannot break the double team, whistle and a jump ball. Alternating possession arrow should go to Newman, and that'll take us to the media timeout. 28-21, your score. Lubbock Christian with their biggest lead of the afternoon. Back after this on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Back at the UMAC here in Tulsa, Oklahoma, you see the Newman cheerleaders and dance squad performing as their team trails 28-21. Drew Brent, Corey Riggs here at courtside. Jose Harbor is our man on the sideline. We'll have another report from him coming up in just a little bit. But, you know, partner, let's talk about this. Once again, field goal shooting percentages for both of these teams. I don't want to use the word abysmal, but for both squads, it's not been up to par.
Oh, no. I mean, 9 of 35 if you're the Jets, 10 of 32 for the Lady Shaps. The biggest difference right now, Newman still sitting on an 0 for 10 day from three-point land, 2 of 13 for Lubbock Christian, and that's why they're up 7.
Here's Ortiz now on that near side wing, and James, who seems to have a natural athleticism, you can see in her ball movement, but sometimes she misses control. Two-pointer on the way off the back of the window. Nice job by Natalia Hausman. That would be 10 for her.
That would be, the bank is open in Tulsa on a Friday. Just one of five international players for Newman. They've got players from Brazil, Australia, Macedonia, and England, all playing and moving to Wichita, Kansas for women's basketball.
Ruffy at the top of the key. Once again, deep inside the shot clock. 7 seconds, 6 seconds. Can't find it. Ball flies out of bounds after a little bit of contact from Shianna James. A little bit of conversation on the court as to whose ball it should be, but it will be Lubbock Christian. And the inbounds pass will come from Delaney Gaddis.
Only 4 on the shot clock here.
There it is, Olivia Robertson, inside cut, can't get it to fall. Wide open look off the front of the iron. And they're gonna call Robertson with the foul on the backcourt, but that play was pretty much indicative of the entire game. Take a look at it.
It's a microcosm of the entire day, and that foul was nothing more, Drew, than a frustration foul.
Exactly.
She blew a 95% jump shot that you'll make every day, 100 times a day, and then turns around and commits the foul. Look at Tess Bruffy now, capping another shot from Newman and forcing a turnover.
Alexander's not been able to find her shot underneath, and a lot of that has to do with Tess Bruffy. That big wingspan of hers, just trying to eliminate any kind of paint shot, and so far it's been effective for Newman, and now Cunyas loses her handle on the basketball, and it'll be jump ball. Alternating arrow should stay with the Shaps.
Shooting percentages for both teams creeping up into the 30% range. But when you talk about the difference in this game, turnovers are even at 11. Rebounds are even at 25. But the difference is at the free throw line, Lubbock Christian, 6 of 8. That's twice as many as Newman's had, 3 of 4. And then those two made three-pointers get you to the lead.
Harbin back in. She gave it to Bruffy, and now Bruffy to Heist. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Robertson, Heist, 2 seconds, pops up, three-pointer on the way, in and out, no good. And that was a pretty shot from our angle, partner. I thought we had it there.
It was online, just a little too strong.
James did the circle, gets it out to Ortiz in the corner, inside to Hausman in the paint, two-point turnaround, Bruffy, all hand it looked like there.
Got her with the hip, though. Absolutely, and that's what makes officiating such a unique science. You want to look at the ball? Go ahead, look at the ball. She doesn't hit her in the hand, but
it's
her hip check is what landed her the foul. That's Mally Wright going to the line now.
And that's Tess Bruffy's first. And, you know, we've talked to officials throughout this tournament. There are some things that you can look for, and while the folks in the stands are going, well, it was all hand, they're right. But the officials are saying something different.
You have to see the entirety of the play and the entirety of the body there that time. And up top it was clean, the rest of it wasn't.
100% that time for Mally Wright from the stripe, 28-25. Now a three-point differential between these two teams as Robertson takes it in the wing, now dribbling to the rim. Two-point shot will not fall. James had a hand on it, will kick it out. This time to Harbin, three-pointer on the way. Still will not fall. Newman with the rebound. It's going to go to Sierra. Jaden should kick it to James, who will take it into transition. They'll reset the offense. Two-pointer on the way off the back of the iron. Will not fall. Once again, story of the game. We can harp on it all day. Newman can't find the shot.
And Tess Bruffy now has more rebounds than she has points, Drew. She's got 8 boards to go with her 6 points.
Bruffy on the inside kicks it out. Robertson for a 3. It's up, and it's in. Olivia Robertson finally able to get a 3-point shot to fall from Kerrville, Texas. The 5'10 sophomore extends this lead 31-25.
Olivia Robertson, again, it's people you're not used to shooting the three that are making them for Lubbock Christian. That's her seventh made three-pointer this season.
Houseman maybe got away with a little push-off there as Harbin will dish to Heist. Heist abruptly inside to Cunha's three-pointer on the way and in. That was an excellent offensive play in transition. Good ball movement. That's more the style that we are used to from Lubbock Christian. Whistle and a timeout. Looks like a 30-second timeout. And we will take it with them. Stay with us. More to come here from the UMAC in Tulsa.
We are here today in the Rip Griffin Center at the men's and women's basketball games, and we presented a wish to Angel Martinez. We brought him in as our guest. Throughout the whole game, we would have little contests and things that he would win. Our first surprise was to do a name drawing, and then he got a signed basketball from our basketball players. Our second surprise for Angel was he got to go on the court and drive a remote control car into each Star Wars figure. And everyone that
provide for 16 threes.
There you see, three-point shot. It's the instant replays that we were looking at, the highlights here.
The banker
the second
for Houseman.
Half. And then Olivia Robertson just before the break. You were talking about it during the break there, partner. Not somebody who you are used to seeing make down the three, but that's sort of the story of the game as we welcome you back to the UMAC.
No, you've got to find a different hero at different times, and Olivia Robertson only has six made threes coming into today. And then it was... wasn't Blakey, I think it was Gaddis. It was Delaney Gaddis had the other three. So two players that have combined for a sum total of 16 threes on the season managed to come in here this afternoon and knock down two very important threes that have given their team, you know, they're back to their largest lead of the day here, up 8 points.
Drew Britt, Corey Riggs courtside here for this quarterfinal matchup. Jose Harbor, our man on the sideline, we'll hear from him here in just a little bit. Steal from Olivia Robertson, and some fierce, fierce contact there.
I think that was jaw meets shoulder in an inadvertent collision here. Watch the replay. See Houseman, and she just kind of got ran over that time by Olivia Robertson. Wow.
Now that was quite the contact there. She took that one on the chin quite literally. You can see her there. Natalia Houseman
walking it off.
Just about a minute to play here in the third quarter. We'll hear from Jose at the end of this quarter. There's Robertson in the corner. Chitsy in the paint, two-pointer off the glass, will not go. The rebound goes to Mally Wright.
Chitsy 2 of 8 shooting today, and that sounds like a rough day, but that's kind of the day everybody's having trying to shoot from the floor.
Here's Wright in the paint, two-pointer and a charge. Drop the shoulder.
Well, Mally Wright finally made up her mind. She was going to take it to the rack. That time, elevation, and the player for Lubbock Christian beat her to the spot. The rule of her own verticality, she stayed straight up and down and draws the charge. Man, that pumps up a bench when you get a player stepping in and taking that offensive foul.
Here's Chitsy on the outside, as you mentioned, 2 for 8, trying to find her shot. 30 seconds to play here in the third quarter. 16 on the shot clock. Two-pointer up, reverse layup off the back of the glass. Nice and easy that time, or at least made it look that way for Hannah Harbin.
Harbin with 6 points now, and that reverse is kind of her signature move. That's the second time we've seen her go underneath like that.
And here comes Lubbock Christian again. It's Robertson. You've got 7 seconds, 6, 5 seconds now, trying to find the shot. Harbin inside, three-pointer on the way at the buzzer. Will not go this time for Delaney Gaddis. Could not make that one fall. And we have reached the end of the third quarter. Let's send it now down to our man, Jose Harbor, who's got a report for us. Jose?
Thanks, guys. Now, Lubbock Christian won the Division II National Championship last year. And in kind of a little tradition, D2 champs play D1 champs, which is, of course, the UConn women of Connecticut. Now, as we all know, they've won over 100 games, and they beat Lubbock, Texas, 95-39. Which Lubbock's coach said was a great experience, which is rare to say when you lose by 56 points. But I can tell you guys, they were up 4-0, Lubbock was, on UConn to start the game, and they almost quit right there.
I don't think that I would have blamed them at that point, partner. Nice report there by Jose, you know, UConn in Division One ranks probably unparalleled. And
yeah,
you draw the comparisons to Pat Summit and some of the great teams from Tennessee. But, wow, what an incredible experience for Lubbock Christian.
Over 100 straight wins now for the UConn Huskies women's basketball program. Gino Auriemma, arguably now the winningest coach at any level, men's, women's, it just doesn't matter. What he's done in Storrs, Connecticut is unbelievable, and it's a neat deal. I saw the same thing a few years ago. I covered Drury University basketball, and the men won the D2 National Championship. Their reward the following year was to go to the Cameron Indoor Stadium and get a chance to play Duke in an exhibition game. And so I just think that's a really neat thing that the NC2A does for their Division I to Division II programs.
You can also see the differences and similarities in programs when you're looking at the best of the best from all divisions. Final quarter of play, 10-point differential. The defending national champions and the women's side of the D2 are up on Newman by 10. Two-pointer on the way, off the iron, will not go. The rebound brought down by Bailey Heist. Here's to Bruffy. A lot of contact inside. Chitsey, two-pointer off the glass, and good. And we saw Mally Wright take one and take some contact quite hard. And she was favoring that leg just a little bit, but she's going to try to walk it off.
She's got a big knee brace on that left leg, so you know she's got a lingering injury at the end of the regular season. Everybody does.
Alexander pushing hard inside the paint. Cannot make it go.
I like the decision to bring it back out and try to reset here.
It's only a 10-point game. Points are at a premium. Three-pointer on the way. It's up, and it's in. Hannah Alexander from Farmington, Minnesota, drops the tray ball. It's 37-28.
All of a sudden, you go from a double-digit deficit to just 9.
Here's Heist, two-pointer, and they answer right back. Colorado Springs, Colorado native, drives the rim and puts 2 up. Another 2 on the other side, cannot fall. Here's Bruffy with the rebound, and Lubbock Christian going to quicken the pace up a little bit. Here's Harbin in the corner. Inside to Chitsey. Chitsey turn around off the glass. Will not go. Whistle and a foul.
Harbin now with 9 rebounds at her per game average, but well below scoring. She's got 6 points today. Normally scores 16. They have really found something, though, the coaching staff for Lubbock Christian and Steve Gomez, that they like going down low to Bobby Chitsey, the 6'1 sophomore back at the line here. She's got 10 points on a 3 of 9 shooting day. She is a perfect 4 of 4 at the line.
Make it 5 of 5 that time, partner. And that will extend the lead 40-28. Second one forthcoming, 8:26 to play in the game. Isaac tries it and missed it. That's our first miss from behind the stripe today. Here's James for Newman, and they're going to reset the offense. You see a couple of times in this game, James loses her handle on the basketball, and it flies out of bounds, and it's going to go Lubbock Christian's way. You know, we talked a little bit about James earlier in the game. Very, very athletic, but sometimes loses control of her body, and that time, another prime example.
You can tell it's one of those things, Drew, with a player like Shianna James. She is athletically gifted, but maybe not has had the progression in her basketball skills. But she's got a body type and an ability that she's able to keep up on the floor, even though that those finely honed skills may not be the same as some other players. But a lot of coaches will take athleticism over anything. They can coach them up on the rest.
Right, you can coach fundamentals, but that's just pure talent. And we saw that from Shianna James quite a bit. There's a lot of contact right here in front of the bench. And that's going to be a timeout. Lubbock Christian will have more right after this on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Back at the Union Multipurpose Athletic Complex in Tulsa, Oklahoma. It is a 40-28 game. Lubbock Christian leading Newman in this quarterfinal matchup. Day two of the 2017 Heartland Conference Championship Tournament. Alongside Corey Riggs, my name is Drew Brent. Thank you for being with us here today. Jose Harbour will have a report for us here in just a little bit. But right now, an inbounds pass to Lubbock Christian, whistle and stoppage. They're going to call that foul on Natalia Hausman. And as you heard the PA announcer maybe mention, that is number four for her. Foul trouble, not a good thing for Newman right now, down by 12.
No, and Hausman's been a big part of their offense all day, one of two double-digit scorers for the Jets, and there's another Newman foul underneath.
That was Bruffy to Harbin, and as you mentioned, that pass on the inside from Bruffy to Harbin is something they've been very used to over a number of years that goes even beyond Lubbock Christian.
Before it was Lubbock Christian, it was the Lubbock Titans. They were members, Harbin and then both the Bruffy sisters, members of the same homeschooled basketball team in the Lubbock, Texas area. So there is a lot of passes and a lot of floor time between the two Bruffies and Harbin.
Harbin behind the line drains the first one. Second one on the way is up. She misses, and the rebound will go to Sierra Jaden. James driving. There's Jaden. Three-pointer on the way. It's up, and it's good. It's a long two. From my vantage point, it looks like three. It'll be 41-30. Jose Harbour has a report for us on the sidelines. Jose?
Thanks, guys. I was listening to the timeout to Lubbock Christian. And coach wants him to use their size. He feels he has a good size advantage against Newman and wants him to be patient. Go in, go out, and pass the ball around. Eat up some clock because they know that neither team is on a hot streak right now.
All righty, Jose, thank you so much. During that, another two-point score. It's 43-30. Lubbock Christian out on top. Two-point answer by Alexander, and all of a sudden the gloves are coming off and so have the lids. Alexander answers right back. 43-32, your score now.
Well, what Jose overheard in the timeout is exactly what they're doing. Watch Chitsy and Bruffy here. They're the ones that are the primary shot takers right now, and they're taking those shots in the paint, getting points in the paint, and that's how they're keeping a double-digit lead.
45-32, Lubbock Christian leading Newman right now. And there's James now at the top. Inside dish, Hausman, two-point shot. Chitsy and Bruffy had their arms straight up, physical underneath, but a whistle and a foul.
Finish up that last thought. Specifically, when you're talking about points of the paint, you look at the scoreboard. Lubbock Christian scored 45 points, more than half. 28 points have been scored inside that rectangle.
First shot on the way and good. Natalia Hausman, who's had a great game for Newman today. Comparatively. Second shot on the way and in. Inbounds pass to Bruffy now. Bruffy is harassed in the backcourt. 6.5 to play. Here's Harbin. Harbin moving to the far side wing. Now back out to the top of the circle. Bruffy trying to find Chitsy inside. And a nice dish. Just will not fall. Chitsy trying to get that rebound. Wrestling for it. But it goes to the Jets anyway.
She almost outworked three Jets that time. It was her against three defenders. And Newman came away with it.
Three-pointer on the way. Off the back of the iron. No good. Here's Harbin with the rebound. And now Lubbock Christian will take it again. Here's Robertson for three-point land. Eyed it, decided not to, and now will work her way back out of the paint. Driving to the rim, two-point shot will not go. Harbin looks like a rebound. Then she kicked out to Bruffy for three, cannot get it to fall. And Newman will rebound once again. Shooting woes have continued despite an 11-point lead.
They've gotten more points to fall in the second half, but it's still not a prolific shooting day for either club.
Underneath, two-point shot will not go, and now the rebound going to the Jets. Hausman and Alexander nearly collided. A cross-court pass now along the baseline. Two-point shot. Maybe took an extra step, but she got away with it. That's Kristevska on that two-point shot, and it's 45-36. Back to a single-digit deficit between these two teams with just about 5 minutes to play. Chitsy at the top of the key.
It's funny what different sets of eyes see. You saw maybe an extra step. I was looking for the foul call.
Here's Robertson, cross court to Harbin, underneath, driving the rim, two-point shot. That's the bread and butter right there.
Well, that's what Coach Gomez wants. That was a shot taken and made with 4 seconds left on the shot clock. A long, controlled possession with points.
You know, when you go deep into the shot clock with possession and ball control, that's one thing. If you go deep into the shot clock because you can't find the shot, Alexander for the three, it won't go. If you go deep into the shot clock because you can't find the shot, that's another. Kristevska drives the rim. They call the foul on Bruffy. That's her second. Eva Kristevska, the Macedonian, will go to the line. Shot on the way, and she gets it to fall. Back to a 10-point lead.
82% free throw shooter this year. Nice round of applause now as Bobby Chitsy comes back to the Lubbock Christian bench. But 82%, 19 of 23 on the season for Kristetsova.
And she makes them both. Bruffy will inbound and gets it into Harbin. Harbin in the backcourt pushes. Lubbock Christian resetting. They're up by 9.
Still plenty of time in this game, though. These are two teams that, in their two earlier meetings, both games that they split were decided by a total of 6 points. 1 point in one game, 5 points in the other. You expect them to be close when these two teams meet on the floor.
Hannah Alexander just picked up her third foul underneath, and will send Olivia Robertson to the line. Her first shot on the way. Pinball's in.
An 88% free throw shooter, 58 of 66 coming into this afternoon. One of the types of players that coaches like to have on the line in close games.
Second shot on the way and in. Made it look easy that time, did Robertson. 49-38, back to an 11-point lead. Newman picking up the pace now, inside. Here's Hausman, now Mally Wright, two-point shot, turn around. Up and in. Little kiss off of the window that time, and maybe some momentum for Newman, at least in the paint. With 3:50 to play, it's a 49-40 game. Robertson will drive. Three-pointer on the way from Bruffy, off the back of the iron, no good again, but a rebound goes to Lubbock Christian, and she gets called for the travel.
She was. The defense came in and closed so quickly on her that she didn't want to bump into the defensive player, so she started falling backwards. Nothing wrong with that Newman defense, just sometimes gravity gets the best of us.
Right, exactly. Gravity was the best defense for the Jets that time. It was the right call. Two-pointer off the window again. Mally Wright, all-conference honoree before this tournament began, and it's now 49-42, back to a 7-point deficit. A lot of basketball to play here. 3:18 to play in the game.
Mally Wright, the third Jet today to get into double-figure scoring now with 10 points and 9 rebounds. One rebound away from a double-double for the second team all-conference standout. There's a reach and foul against Bruffy.
That is number 5 for Natalia Hausman. She will go to the bench. She is done for the day. She will send Bruffy to the line. That's not good news for Newman, as Hausman has 10 points and has been pretty good for this Newman team.
She's been great today. 10 points, 5 rebounds. She was perfect at the charity stripe. She shot 50% from the floor.
And Bruffy misses her first one.
Tess Bruffy shoots 62.5% from the free throw line.
As you mentioned, partner of the conference player of the year, and is able to drain that one. extends it out to a 50-42 lead. Here's Alexander in the wing. Newman trying to find that open shot, can't quite get there. Was looking in the wing. 2-point shot up off the window and in. Good shot that time by Newman. In the last three consecutive scoring possessions for Newman, you've seen exactly that same play.
Well, Lubbock Christian is fell in love with that 3-2 zone defense. And finally, Newman is starting to find lanes here in the late minutes that open up that zone to attack.
It's 50-44, 2.5 to play. Win, advance, and go home, or loser goes home.
Can Newman get another stop here? They've cut it to 6. Instead, they foul.
And they call that one on. They call it on Sierra Jaden. As you mentioned, she's been playing with a broken thumb for a number of weeks.
Just tape it up and play, man. That's what you got to do this time of year. And Jaden's no different.
It's Hannah Harbin, the 5'10 senior. Hometown is Lubbock, Texas, as you mentioned earlier, 51-44.
Some of the folks from Lubbock here you saw on the screen that made the road trip to Oklahoma for this tournament weekend.
Here it is inside, 2-point shot, gorgeous form from Mally Wright. That's Newman's bread and butter, 52-46, and we wondered if they were picking up some momentum in the paint. Well, I think that was your answer.
Well, they found a soft spot in the zone for Mally Wright to be able to attack Chitsey and Bruffy. She's been able to do it. I think she's got about 6 points here in the fourth quarter.
Inside, here's Bruffy on the wing. She's going to drive the rim. 2-point shot will not go. Alexander tried to take the charge. Whistle on a foul.
They'll get Mally Wright with the foul. That is only her second. Surprising, the post is able to get cleanly to the fourth quarter with only one foul prior to this one. A pretty hard strike that time. Going to put Lubbock Christian back on the line. Olivia Robertson, it's not her first trip to the line today.
As you mentioned earlier, partner, 88% from the free throw line. She's not the one you want to send to the charity stripe.
As a team, they're shooting 73.7%, 14 of 19, make it 15 of 20. Give Newman credit, though. They're 9 of 10 at the free throw line today.
Inside lane, and there's that double team. Blocked off that lane, but for three, it's up, and it's good. Goodness gracious, Eva Krzyzewska, they find the double team, but they find the three-pointer.
They trap and a timeout by Steve Gomez's bench. Able to kind of bail them out here, Drew, as they're going to use a full timeout here. But we've seen for the last couple of minutes this sort of trap at midcourt. That time it was almost right in between the midcourt line and the free throw line, right in front of Lubbock Christian's bench. They got the double team over, trapped, and they have to burn the timeout. 5-point game with a minute 24 to go. I tell you what, if Newman can find a quick basket or a three, this game changes again. They're hovering around that magic number we talked about in the first half of 4 points.
Well, and one of the things that we have mentioned, too, in the first half, you just couldn't seem to find your shots to fall on the ladder. 5 minutes or so, they've finally found an offensive rhythm, have both teams. Just have to wonder if that's going to equate to the last team to score wins almost, one of those kinds of situations. But if you take a look at the statistics that we are looking at right now, Natalia Hausman, who fouls out 10 points, she was right behind Mally Wright and Hannah Alexander, 13 and 12 respectively. But I mean, only really four major offensive players of production for Newman so far. You would also think that Tess Bruffy would have had a bigger game. She's been quiet from a scoring perspective with 9 points. Bobby Chitsey, 13 points. Delaney Gadnis with 3. Olivia Robertson and Hannah Harbin with both 11 points apiece. And Harbin will inbound it directly in front of our broadcast position here. She finds Heist, and we're ready to play again. 80 seconds to play in this game. Here's Heist.
This is probably the last possession, Drew, before Newman has to start fouling.
And you'll see Lubbock Christian try to work down that shot clock. They have 8 seconds. Bruffy, 2-pointer. Nice little move on the inside. Gets to the rim, puts two up. It's 56-49.
11 points and 9 rebounds for your Heartland Conference Player of the Year today.
Flies out of bounds, fingertipped by Newman. Lubbock Christian will get possession of the basketball.
Mally Wright, it was too tall for Mally Wright, and at 6'1", that's saying something.
Whistle, and there you see the fouls. This is what you called it. That was the final possession before they start fouling, and they're going to send Chitsey to the line.
Now you got to you're in the spot now where you've got to start trying to trade 2 for 3, and you hope that you get a miss. You hope that somebody goes 50% at the free throw line, but these teams have shot extremely well. I mean, 75% today as a team for Lubbock Christian. They put Bobby Chitsey on the line now, who's 5 of 6. Now she's 6 of 7 at the free throw line today. Maybe going to have to pick a different target to send to the line. I'm looking up and down here trying to see somebody that struggled today, and I say only Tess Bruffy's got the low water mark at 50% at the free throw line.
Which is a stark contrast to their field goal percentages. Free throws and charity stripes have been great. Three-pointer on the way. It's up, and it is no good. Love it. Christian with the rebound. Foul underneath, and Bruffy hits the floor.
And as long as they give the rebound control to Tess Bruffy, that'll give her yet another double-double on this great season for the junior from Lubbock, Texas. She's now got 11 points and 10 rebounds, and she will be the one that walks to the free throw line, shooting only 3 of 6 from the line this afternoon.
Lubbock Christian will send 3 back. Bruffy will have 2. Up and in.
We've talked about Tess Bruffy, the way she alters shots, the way she blocks shots. This team led the nation in blocks last year. This year, they're 3rd in blocks per game and 6th in total blocks as a team. Coming into today, they had 155. They got a few more to add to that total after this afternoon.
Back to a 10-point differential now. In the wing is Alexander. Look for the 3. Couldn't find it. 3-pointer on the way. Off the back of the iron and no good. Whistle and a foul on Harbin.
I thought that would look good that time. Out of the grip of Sierra Jade. We kind of had the backside angle on it. Thought it was going to go that time, but instead another foul. And we'll take the long walk to the opposite end of the lane, and they'll put Hannah Harbin back at the line.
Newman has to start scoring. That's one of the, I mean, it's one of those things that you say all of the time as the first shot is up and it misses. But when you have those possessions, if you want to stay in this game and you have to foul, you've got to score.
These two teams have combined for 5 three-pointers today. That's it, 5 three-pointers. And in the modern college basketball era, that just doesn't happen. They've both been cold.
3 on the way. It's up and it's in. How about Jasmine Ortiz? And that was a long-range 3 that time, able to make that one. It's a timeout on the floor. And we will stay right here. With just about 25 seconds left to play in this ball game.
It was a perfect time for me to make an emphatic statement about how poor the three-point shooting had been today and then see an NBA range 3 go through the net. Great shot for Jasmine Ortiz. Her first make of the day. She's 1 for 3 from three-point land, but a timely one here. You get a couple of misses. They're going to foul immediately on the inbounds. And then all of a sudden, we'll be off to the races again and see what happens at the free throw line.
25 seconds left, 60-52. If you're Coach Gomez, if you're Coach Spence, what are you telling your teams?
Well, Coach Spence is just trying to extend the game. It's foul quickly, trade 3 for 2 here. They finally got a 3 to go. See how fast the foul comes, and they're going to put Bruffy back at the line, who's had the most struggles today, usually only going 1 for 2 when she goes to the stripe.
But as we mentioned with the foul strategy, you're trying to trade 3 for 2, but if you're not hitting the 3, it's not helping.
No, it's not. But as I say, this was a 10-11 point game 30 seconds ago. It's now an 8-point game, and that's all you can do is lengthen the game as long as you can, because you're trying to lengthen your season. This is going to be the end of the run for the Newman Jets here if the scoreboard stays set the way it is, and they'll finish their season with 19 wins and 10 losses. And Lubbock Christian will move on to Saturday here in Tulsa.
Second shot, she misses them both. The rebound goes to Newman. Here's Kostrzewska. Looking. Alexander for 3. Off the mark. No good. Rebound goes this time to Heist, who hits the floor very, very hard. Problem with that is that exchange took about 10 seconds off the clock. And they will send Bailey Heist, 5'6 senior, to the line.
Heist has not had a trip to the free throw line today. This will be her first trip. 5 points, 6 rebounds, 1 assist today for the guard wearing number 3.
First is up and first is in. Delaney Gaddis back into the game now. Take Bobby Chitsey out.
Like the way Chitsey played today. 15 points to lead her team in scoring. That 15 leads all scorers this afternoon.
Second shot on the way and in. 13, 12 seconds now. Krzyzewska driving the rim. 2-point shot. Gets it up and in. Pretty in textbook, but once again, about 8 seconds taken off the clock. Newman will take a timeout. And it's a full timeout. So with 7.7 seconds left, we'll have the finale of this one right after this on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about
as we welcome you back to the UMAC. 62-54, Lubbock Christian is leading with just about 6.8 seconds left. The 8-point differential, if it holds, Lubbock Christian, the 3 seed, will move on, which will mean the top 3 seeds of this women's bracket have moved on so far. Robertson has it roll out of her, and you can see the look on her face.
Well, the ball rolled out of the cylinder, and Robertson's eyes nearly rolled out of her head. She was so frustrated at that miss.
Second shot on the way. She makes that one, drains it, 63-54. 6 seconds, 5 seconds, 4 seconds. Krzyzewska Alexander to the wing, 3-pointer on the way. It's up and it's good. A gorgeous three that time, 63-57. But with 0.4 seconds left, that's all she wrote, and that's it. Lubbock Christian will advance to the number 3 seed. We'll knock off the number 6 seed. Newman Jets had a heck of a run and a heck of a stand. But the Jets not able to hold on. Coach Steve Gomez, we're expecting to join Jose Harbor in just a few moments. But as we await that, number 1, number 2, and number 3 all move on, partner.
Number 2, St. Mary's now, the next opponent for the 3rd-seeded Lubbock Christian Lady Shaps. That'll be an interesting matchup, partner, because St. Mary's has got some nice height to them, more than Newman did today, so there may be some very interesting matchups with Tess Bruffy and Bobby Chitsey.
All right, let's send it to Jose Harbor, who has Coach Steve Gomez.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Coach Steve Gomez. Coach, it was a pretty hard-fought game, kind of low-scoring. It seemed hard for both teams to score. Just talk about it.
Hey, Newman's good. I mean, they're always so solid. They defend well and ruggedly. They're tough. And they offensively make good plays. They don't make many mistakes on offense. So we knew it was going to be a possession-by-possession game. You know, they didn't shoot it as well from the perimeter as they have in some games. And, you know, neither team shot it great. So, you know, you may look at what, an 8-point game or something. Really, it was 2 or 4-point game. You know, either team could have won that game.
I know you're going to relish in the win for a little bit, but you got a couple teams that are playing that you're going to be playing next. Just kind of talk about what you're looking for.
Yeah, there's no relish this time of year. We'll relish whenever the season's over. You know, yeah, we got to get in there and rest and hydrate and be ready to play tomorrow at 2:30. But, there's a lot of teams in this tournament that can win it, and we just want to be one that gives ourselves a chance. So we're going to eat lunch, rest, get off our feet, and get ready for tomorrow.
Hey, Coach, appreciate it. Drew, back to you.
Jose, good work as always. Coach Steve Gomez winning another one here in the Heartland Conference Tournament. And Partner, as we get set for the second game, we have to just take a look at the statistics here. 22 of 62 for Newman, 19 of 52 for Lubbock Christian. Poor shooting, and if Lubbock Christian wants to get past to the finals, they're going to have to work on that.
I don't think you're going to see another day like today, Drew. The great thing about a bad shooting day for a good team, you don't have them very often. Their march to another trip to the postseason continues tomorrow.
Oklahoma Christian and the Fort Smith Lady Lions are coming up right after this at 2:30 on the Heartland Conference Sports Network. Post-game press conference right after this. Don't go anywhere.
Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask?
All right, see y'all in a little bit.
How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The National SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved. Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask if I have any problems? How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The National SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved.
Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask if I have any problems? How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The national SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved. Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask if I have any problems? How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The national SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved. Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Do you want more recognition for your team?
Who should I ask if I have any problems? How can I share my ideas?
How can you get involved and make it yours? Joining Student Athlete Advisory Committee allows your voice to be heard.
The mission of SAC is to enhance the total student athlete experience by promoting opportunity, protecting welfare, and fostering a positive image. Who is SAC?
SAC members are student athletes supporting other student athletes. SAC members vote on rules, partner with great organizations such as Make-A-Wish and Team Impact, and build pride on campus and in the community.
There are three different levels of SAC to get involved in. At the campus level, there are 307 Division II institutions that sponsor SAC. Each campus SAC is led by an athletic administrator and a committee made up of student athletes from a variety of athletic teams.
There are 24 Division II conferences, each with their own conference SAC. The representatives share best practices, success stories, and new ideas that can be brought back to each campus SAC.
The national SAC is made up of one student athlete from each of the 24 Division II conferences. These student athletes are your voice and are charged with the responsibility of relaying the overall student athlete voice for the division.
Your voice has value.
Get involved. Take ownership in your experience.
Leave a legacy.
Make it yours!
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports. Athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up.
Play Newman, that's a tough team to play. I thought two rugged teams trying to scrap it out. We just had a foul line of them. They defend well. They're they just put themselves in binds in games. They always are going to be right there. They don't give up long runs. And so we just going to probably be a one or two possession one way or the other. And that's every year how we play. So it's a credit to them. They kids. Luckily, they didn't shoot it well. And so that's just the way it went today. I appreciate it.
What are your thoughts on your balance offensively?
Yeah, real important this time of year. We can't get spoiled and think that's just going to happen every game. They defended well. Mally's physically long and smart, and then they sunk people on her when she caught a lot of space. And so we have to have some others do the job. And so it was good for Bobby Chitzy, who's last weekend had two double-figure games. She's sort of getting healthy again after being out a while. Someone can score. Olivia gave us – that was a big performance by her. She's had big games and some games she hasn't done as much, but today we needed it. She made a three-point shot that was sort of just the turning point of that game where we were struggling. She hits and that sort of got us relaxed a little more.
I think it's frustrating whenever you're on offense and you just can't make a shot, but that's when you have to play defense and just step it up. You're starting, you just have to, and you have to rely on your teammates to be able to pick up the points that you're not making. And so I think we did a really good job about other people stepping up and scoring for us. And even though we kind of struggled, I think we still really stuck together. And
for me, I think it's just playing with teammates and knowing that a lot of times I can dive and be on balance because I can have a mismatch with a small guard on me, even outside when you have to have post players. And it's real helpful when they're always test and on balance.
Yeah, and sometimes defense, good defense can be masked by missing shots. So we had shot violations every possession to give them opportunities. They just missed some shots. And so I thought they're difficult to defend in man because they're quick, they're versatile. And so we decided today we just played mostly zone against them. And again, they executed man offense good against that zone, though, a lot of times, and just missed some shots. But our length inside all year long, when they get around the basket, it's helpful with Tess around the basket to at least alter some shots. And then defensively, our guards worked hard. I mean, those games, both teams just really gave it their all, and both teams defended well. I mean, I thought they defended really well. So a couple key positions, I can go back and watch. Well, if that wouldn't have happened, I'm not here right now.
Talk about how you're seeing.
season has been having to replace so many key pieces from last year, and what your mindset is coming into the Heartland tournament this year and hopefully making the playoffs?
Probably last year, but we're a different team this year, and we're really to just adjust, and you know, we had to figure out our team chemistry at first, and it's been a rough time. I mean, we've been trying to figure out who's the leaders, and I think we finally kind of got out, and we're ready for postseason. We just want to go with again, and we're enjoying each other. I trust my teammates. So.
I mean, right now is the best time to have a team out of regular conference play with four home games, with four home wins. The best thing that could possibly happen is to leave our home court having more home games and then come into conference momentum.
He's coming up next. Really athletic. A lot of really good guard play in our efforts. Obviously, it's really versatile for the things that you guys are going to have to do differently or better going into next game.
Yeah. Their team has been strong all year. They hurt you is on their end. You know, they may not have a lot of production at some possessions. They're going to come out because they defend. You got to limit those bodies where you give yourself a chance to play against them. Kids that can shoot. How close do I get to her? She can on a rebound. She can offensive rebound, stick it in. Post. She shoots a three. So, sort of a, again, I had the same concerns with Newman. I name players. It'll be a tough battle for efficient. Our offense. We're gonna have to let our offense help our defense, and that's the key.